Welcome to the new crafting guide. This time I will show you how to craft one-hand sword for melee physical crit builds. The best base to use is jeweled foil item level 83. This base has the best combination of implicit, 25% to global critical strike multiplier, DPS and attack speed. You need to use item level 83 if you wish to have a chance to get tier 1 mod for hybrid physical damage and for physical damage. Also, you should avoid using the higher item level because you will have a chance to get some mods you don't need. For this crafting, the best 6 mods to get are Dictator tier 1 mod for hybrid physical and accuracy, Merciless tier 1 mod for increased physical damage, Flaring tier 1 mod for adds physical damage, tier 1 for increased attack speed, tier 1 for global critical strike multiplier, and hybrid mod from crafting bench, increased critical strike chance and 2 quality. I looked on trade and I was able to find one such sword in the standard league with all these 6 mods and with the price of 430 exalts, which is no wonder as this sword have over 680 physical DPS. Chance to get all these mods together is really small, so you will need to add missing mods with your crafting bench. Here are the best mods you can add. For endgame, your goal is to craft minimum 400 physical DPS sword, and to get this minimum, you can craft a rare weapon with just one mod, and then add the rest of the mods with your crafting bench. That one mod can be Merciless increase physical damage, or Flaring adds to physical damage, or even Hybrid tier 1 or tier 2 physical damage and accuracy. If you get one of these mods in combination with tier 2 or tier 1 attack speed and add the rest of the mods with crafting bench, you can expect between 450 and 500 DPS. Also, nice 2 mods combination is increased physical damage with hybrid increased physical damage and 2 accuracy rating. Combined increased physical damage should be minimum 190. Keep in mind, with this combination, the third prefix is reserved for adds to physical damage and there is no space for hits can be evaded. For this crafting, it is important to increase the quality of the weapon. Before you start crafting, you can use perfect fossils to increase quality to 30%, or you can use Hillock Rank 3 Transportation Crafting Bench to increase quality to 28%. For this weapon, I used 10 perfect fossils and the best result I got was 27%. One of the reasons I prefer to use Hillock Crafting Bench or Beast Crafting. After you finish crafting, you can still use the Hillock Crafting Bench, but be sure to not use perfect fossils as they will reroll all the mods and ruin your crafting. The second way to increase the quality is to use Beast Crafting and corrupt your weapon for 30% quality. There are several ways to craft this weapon. The most common way is to use Alteration Orbs and try to get a magic weapon with 1 or 2 good mods. If you get 2 really good mods like Merciless and Tier 1 Attack Speed, you can use Beast Crafting to create an imprint of a magic item, which you can use to restore your magic weapon in case you get some bad mod from the Regal Orb. If you don't like crafting with Alteration Orbs and don't mind spending more currency, you can use fossils. You can craft with just Jagged Fossil or go with 3 fossil combination and add Corroded and Prismatic Fossil. Corroded will remove all elemental mods and Prismatic will remove all poison and bleeding mods. Now you will have a higher chance to get the mods you need, but the problem is those mods usually will be low tier and no good for this crafting. To increase the chance to get higher tier mods, you can add Sanctified Fossil to this combination. This will give you the best chance to craft a good weapon, the only problem is crafting cost, which is really high for this way of crafting. For this video I first used 10 single jagged fossils, then 4 combined with corroded and prismatic fossils, and on the end had one try with 4 fossils, where I added Sanctified Fossil. All this was without getting any good crafting result. Besides using alteration orbs and fossils, you can try to craft this weapon with deafening essence of contempt or deafening essence of zeal. The last way is to use chaos orbs to reroll mods on your rare weapon. Crafting cost for each trial is low, but the chance to get anything good is really small. For this crafting I prefer to use alteration orbs, and now I will show you the full crafting process for some weapons I crafted in Blight League. If I get at least one good mod, either prefix or suffix, I will use Regal Orb for a small chance to get a second good mod. I was lucky to get Merciless Prefix, but the other two mods are bad, so now I need to use 2 orbs of annulment and try to remove those bad mods. now, you can try to sell weapon like this, or finish crafting by adding mods with your crafting bench. To finish crafting, first you need to add can have multiple crafted modifiers. Now you can add 4 more mods in any order you wish. Those mods are rank 3, adds to physical damage. Hits can be evaded. Rank 3 attack speed. And rank 2 increase critical strike chance and to quality. Finish crafting will look like the weapon I'm using at the moment. If you plan to corrupt your weapon with beast crafting for 30% quality, be sure to first use divine orbs and try to get maximum or close to maximum rolls for your explicit mods. This will increase damage of your weapon. If you decide to craft these weapons, I wish you best of luck. Thanks for watching and see you next time!